The Marine Corps was established in 1990 as a deterrent against the capability of landing off enemy forces on the Pakistan coastline. Over the years, Pakistan Navy has developed a comprehensive and well-equipped training infrastructure. Facilities exist for specialized training of officers and sailors for various operations, technical and logistic branches. Its training infrastructure is based mainly in Karachi. The major bulk of officers' corps is inducted into the Navy through Pakistan Naval Academy, PNA, where they join as cadets. After having qualified inland staff course, selected officers are also sent abroad for further courses and training in USA, Europe, Far East, and Middle East. Higher courses for naval officers are conducted at National Defense University, Islamabad. The Coastal Command has been organized into three major groups: Special Services Group, Pakistan Marines, ComWest. In line with the rising defense challenges, the Pakistan Navy stands as an effective and efficient arm of the country's armed forces, fully capable of protecting Pakistan's maritime interests and maintaining necessary deterrence. Pakistan Air Force. From its humble beginnings at the time of independence, Pakistan Air Force has emerged as a vital force in the South Asian region to reckon with. Despite heavy odds and limitations, with two fighter and one transport squadron, a negligible infrastructure, non-existent command structure, and almost no maintenance facilities for the Pakistan Aeronautical Complex Kamra to assemble F-6 and Mirage fighter planes. The facility now produces Mushak trainer aircraft and maintains radar and avionics equipment for the Pakistan Air Force. Now, PAF operates 470 plus combat aircrafts in 20 fighter squadrons, an automated network of air defense radars, complex maintenance facilities, and an elaborate administration setup. Its new maintenance concepts and facilities are based on a more direct communication, optimum use of software database, and reliable electronic networks. Accompanying the technological developments, education and training are duly accentuated with special emphasis on research and development. Pakistan's first fighter jet, JF-17 Thunder, has been launched recently. The success story of Pakistani ingenuity and the will to survive repeated American arms embargoes and Indian aggression goes far beyond this single feat. Since the uncertain days of independence in 1947, no other country has come so far in defense production in such a short period of time. In the face of all the hardships and military embargoes, PAF has now reached the epitome of its achievements. JF-17 Thunder is one of the world's most capable multi-role fighter aircraft. Developed by Pakistan and China, it will fulfill PAF requirements well into the mid-21st century with its cutting-edge technology and operational capabilities. The aircraft has been developed in record time when airframe development was delinked from avionics. With an aspiration to achieve excellence, Pakistan Air Force selects young men and women with budding credentials. From a pilot officer to the higher echelons, immensely consequential responsibilities are entrusted to the individuals. This task is accomplished through a thorough system of training, which caters for specialized knowledge about the world, military tactics, and material sciences. The training imparted to the PAF personnel from day one and onwards throughout their career progression is most precisely carved and tailored to make them a whole person. The standard of training maintained in the PAF is recognized all over the world. It is this trustworthy repute that today the Pakistan Air Force has the credit of providing initial and specialized training to the personnel of over 30 allied countries, including professional courses pertaining to flying, engineering, air defense, and miscellaneous types are offered to the officers during their career. In spite of all the odds, the Pakistan Armed Forces have risen to meet all the challenges facing Pakistan, ranging from traditional threats to unconventional dangers like terrorism. While keeping minimum deterrence, they have acquired maximum defense capability with state-of-the-art technology, dedication, and professionalism.